Now let's move on to the on enter frame. So every time a frame is run, this is where the brains of the code is going to go. All right. So the first thing we want to do is we don't necessarily want this code running if the target is idle. Let's pull up the dynamics and is idle. So if the object is idle, we want to know which object, so that's the target. Okay. Then, and I'm going to leave that empty for now. There's something that I'll probably want to do in there, but we're going to deal with the else because we want to deal with the target when it's not idle. All right, so first let's get the. If we're going to be chasing an object, we want to make sure that we have the location of the object. So let's start with, let's call this target X, target Y, oops, and target Z. And we're going to do the object. Let's get the translation. Let's do get. There we go. And it wants to know the object and then the space that we're dealing with. So let's say the target. And we just run off the camera. There we go. And that's going to be global. Oops. There we go. All right. So we're getting the X, Y, and Z coordinates of the location of our object. Let's move this back over a little bit. The next thing we want to do is, if you remember from the vector work, what we decided was that we want to get the velocity of the ball. That we can't count on the axes because the ball may or may not be moving. The axes aren't going to rotate depending on which direction the ball's facing. The only thing we can count on is the velocity. So let's call this V X, V Y. And VZ equals. This is going to be dynamics because we're dealing with a dynamic attribute. Oh, dynamics. There we go. And we're going to do the linear velocity, angular velocity would be dealing with the rotation. So as we can see at the top, we want the object that we're trying to find. So that's going to be that. And again, we're going to do the space, which is the global space. Okay, so we have the location, and now we're getting the velocity. So if you remember from the last video, the next thing we want to do is we want to normalize the vector. Now the interesting thing about the get linear velocity is that, let's say that your object is out at point 100, 100, way out in the global system. Coordinate system, and you're getting the velocity. And let's say it's only moving one unit at a time. It's going one unit in the x direction and one unit in the y direction. Well, the velocity vector is not going to be all the way out at 100 where the object is. So it's not going to be like 101 comma 101. The velocity is represented in the true velocity of the object, and so it's going to be represented by the point 1 comma 1. And so when we're normalizing the vector, all we're doing is I talked about normalizing as moving it to the origin and then setting the magnitude to 1. The velocity, and when it comes back from this function, is already at the origin, so now all it has to do is scale it to 1. In order to do that, I'm just going to go ahead and plug it back into these coordinates here, vx, vy, vz, which is what we were using for our velocity. And this is a call to math because we're dealing with vectors and it's a math function. So there's actually one called vector normalize, and all it does is it asks for the original point or the vector that we were dealing with. So vx, vy, vz. Okay. So it's normalized now, so its magnitude is 1. So now I want to scale it. Because I want to be exactly 10 units away from it, so we're going to scale it by 10. Cannot type. And again, this is a call to math. vector scale. We do the units that we, or the vector that we want to scale. And then we provide, as you can see at the top, a number for the scale. Now this is another thing that I could probably throw in a config file just to make it easier to adjust, but for now I'm just going to set it as negative 10. Now I do negative because I want to be behind the object, so I set it in the negative direction so that I'm moving behind it rather than the velocity is always going forward, well, in the direction that the ball is traveling. Alright, so now the last thing that I need to do, since I have this vector and it's scaled the way I want it, now we need to add it to the position of the ball. Because like I said, the ball could be out at 100, 100, and now we have this vector and we don't want to be, you know, back at the origin or 10 units from the origin because we've scaled it. We want to be 10 units from the ball. So we're going to add the vector. So let's call this local, and now I'm just going to use X, Y, and Z for the actual position. And it's math again. We're doing a vector add. And we just have to take the two vectors that we want to add together. So we're going to start with target, since that's where it's located. Target X, target Y, target Z, and then velocity X, velocity Y, and velocity Z. Okay. So now, the position that we should put our camera at is going to be just simply the X, Y, Z variable that we created to. So let's get that going. We're going to do object translate, because we want to translate to a location, so translate to. And we need the object, which is going to be the camera. The location, which is X, comma Y, comma Z. And then the space. This is, again, we're going to do the global space. Now the next thing we need to do is a factor. So this is basically how long it takes to get there. Let's just set it. I'm trying to keep these. The reason why I'm not throwing these things into config files, I'm trying to keep these videos a little bit shorter. So I'm just going to put them here for now, and then after the video I'll go in and clean things up. Because we all know where we were doing the stuff in the XML and whatnot. So I don't think we have to go over that again. I'm just going to store it there in that file. Okay, the last thing I want to do is once I've moved to the location, I want to look at the ball. It doesn't help if I move to behind the ball if it's not looking at the ball. So we're going to do look at. So we start with the object that we want to change the view of, and it's a coordinate. So we're going to do the position that we got was the target variables, target X, Y, and Z. And again, we always have to say what space we're dealing with. We're going to deal with the global. And then the factor, again, I'm going to set to 0.2. I haven't played with this too much. According to the API documentation, the factor is from 0 to 1. I'm thinking it's, you know, basically a percentage. So if it's at 1, it means that it moves in the 1 frame. It moves all the way. If it's 0.2, then maybe it, you know, it takes 5 frames to get to where it's going. It just kind of smooths things out. So we'll close off the conditional there. Let's hit Control S to save, F7 to compile. Everything looks good. Let's run back over to here. We'll hit play. We'll hit our button. Oh, didn't go anywhere. So one thing you have to always remember to do when you're done with your AI, it's not enough to just have it programmed in. You actually have to assign it to the object. So I'm going to go ahead and reload the scene here. We have our chase camera. Let's make sure it's selected. And we'll drag and drop the chase cam AI into the camera. Come up, save the scene. Let's play it. And voila. Now, you'll notice, I know, the walls are in the way. I was meaning to do just a simple chase cam stuff. I'll straighten it up a little bit more as we go. The other thing you'll notice is that it doesn't immediately go back behind the ball when the ball resets to its original position. That's going to be something easy to fix, but when you do hit the button again, it will jump back there. Just in the wanting to keep these videos a little bit shorter, I'm going to go ahead and just leave it as it is for now, and we'll go back and clean that up. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope it makes sense. Hopefully as we get some of the mechanics down, we'll be able to start adding some other objects, some things to bounce off of. Maybe we'll put the flames in. We just want to kind of prototype things and see how the gameplay is going to be. Then once we get it working the way we want, then we'll go back and we'll actually create a good looking level and we'll do some of the hard work. But I just want to bring up a prototype, play around with it a little bit, just see what it's like to play it. And just see if it's any fun, see if we need to adjust anything before we do all this work creating these assets that, you know, we may end up having to tweak later. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please put them down in the comments or visit my blog, subspacegames.com. Those are the ways that you can get a hold of me, or if you have any comments about the game, then I'm going to, you know, I will update the game based on what we have here. Go ahead and go to the forum, sign up, leave me some comments there. Anyways, hope you enjoy the video and we'll see you next time.